My name is Tasneem Zehra Hussain. I'm a theoretical physicist and a writer. I was asked what image comes to mind when I hear the word scientist, and rather than describe it, I thought I'd try to show you. The image I see is something like this, a collage of people from across the world and through the ages. People who come from a wide range of ethnicities and backgrounds and bring a richness of experience and perspective. I'm going to point out just a few in passing, and even though I'm limiting myself to the physical sciences, this list is very eclectic and incomplete. Let's start with Mary Somerville, for whom the word scientist was coined, and her student Ada Lovelace, together with Hedy Lamarr. These are a few of the Harvard computers, the women who processed astronomical data at the observatory. There's Henrietta Leavitt, Annie Jump Cannon, and Cecilia Payne. There's Marie Curie, along with Jocelyn Bell Burnell and Vera Rubin. Moving along to the present day, here's Priyamvada Natarajan, Jana Levin, and Andrea Ghez, who was just awarded the Nobel Prize. Here are some incredible experimentalists: Qianxuan Yu, Nargis Mawalwala, and Fabiola Gianotti, who recently became the first woman director general of CERN. But of course, not all scientists are women. Among the many fascinating characters in this tapestry are Isaac Newton, Michael Faraday, and James Clerk Maxwell. There's Einstein, of course, and Eddington and Niels Bohr. And here are some of the key actors in the drama of quantum mechanics: Werner Heisenberg, Erwin Schrödinger, and Wolfgang Pauli. Then there's Paul Dirac, the theorist's theorist, Stephen Hawking, whose mind transcended all the limitations of the body, and Abdus Salam, who was an equally brilliant scientist and statesman. There are, of course, so many, many more. But if I had to illustrate the word scientist, I still couldn't pick one. It's not that I'm spoiled for choice, it's that I don't think any single person, no matter how iconic, can do the word justice. Because science is not limited to any one kind of mind or temperament. Behind each of the faces you've just seen lie vastly different personalities and different ways of working, yet they are all equally scientists. All of these passionate, intelligent, committed minds from different times and traditions holding wildly divergent opinions on all manner of issues. And yet, a scientific theory is something they all agree upon. That is what makes it so powerful. And because science draws its strength from diversity, I feel that a collage is a much better representation of the word scientist than any one face alone.